On January 29, 2022, the Taal volcano south of Manila in the Philippines began a new eruptive sequence. Between 3:50 p.m. local time on the 29th and 4:49 a.m. on the 30th, a series of 9 volcanic explosions occurred. These explosions were caused by a shallow magma in a conduit underlying the crater lake heating the overlying water. The overlying water flashed to steam and exploded, in the process ejecting small fragments of lava. After a several-day hiatus of no other explosions, another phreatomagmatic explosion occurred on February 2nd at 3:55 p.m. local time. This small eruption lasted 2 minutes, and in that time span produced a 300-meter-high plume of ash which drifted to the southwest. This plume was subsequently photographed from satellite, although it was relatively small. Since the beginning of 2021, Taal has produced 3 such sequences of phreatomagmatic bursts, which are spread out between a period of between 8 and 10 days. Interestingly, all 3 of these sequences, including the ongoing eruption, have seemingly followed the same pattern. Leading up to the beginning of each eruption, sulfur dioxide emissions emitted at the volcano are consistently high and average more than 10,000 tons emitted each day due to a volume of shallow magma. Then, a series of phreatomagmatic explosions occur for a period of between 1 and 3 days. This is followed by a 3 to 5 day long pause in activity, which in each case marks the midway point of the eruption. The overall eruption subsequently resumes, producing a second series of bursts which are spread out across a period of between 1 and 4 days. After the eruption truly ends, a series of intense volcanic earthquakes strike the volcano, bringing volcanic tremor to levels higher than at any point in the eruptive phase. At the present, it appears that the Taal volcano is in the second half of its overall eruption, as not only did a volcanic explosion occur after a several-day pause, but associated volcanic earthquakes spiked to unusually high levels. In a 24-hour period from February 2nd to February 3rd, 152 volcanic earthquakes were detected. While this number is unusually high, it does not necessarily mean that a larger eruption such as what occurred in 2020 is imminent. During that eruption, there were between 75 and 725 volcanic earthquakes each day. Of course, take everything I just described with a grain of salt, as these 3 separate eruptive sequences are a very small sample size. Regardless, it is still quite unusual that the recent earthquake struck the eastern half of the caldera lake to the east of Taal's main crater. Sulfur dioxide emissions produced by all the shallow magma remains high, but have nearly halved since the eruption began. Whereas 15,633 tons of sulfur dioxide were measured on January 29th, 7,902 tons were measured on February 2nd. The amount of sulfur dioxide emitted each day is often a good indication of how much shallow magma is present. Based on a very low-end estimate, there are at least 10 million cubic meters of magma underneath the volcano, most likely in its magma conduit. While this magma could produce an even larger explosive eruption, it is most likely to remain beneath the surface and occasionally produce smaller eruptions. As of the writing of this video, Taal's alert level remains at 2 on the 5-point scale, meaning that people should stay away from the central island and avoid lengthy stays on the overall Taal Lake. As a final note, I would only worry about a major volcanic eruption occurring if the total number of volcanic earthquakes peaked above 300 a day for at least 2 days in a row. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Carl Huster, for supporting this channel.